And now we see it from England, the bearded collie. And we stay in England for the border collie. And now we go back to Belgium for the Malinois. White Swiss Shepherd Dog. The pulley. Maremmen. And the last competitor in this competition, it's the Welsh Corky Cardigan.
And as I said, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this group will come back on Sunday, perhaps to win this show, to be the best in show of the European Dog Show 2016.
We have 8 semi-finalists in this group. Before we saw 6 every time in the selection, but here we have 8 and they go around once more. And now we have the results. Number 3, number 2, and the winner. Number 3, with a big applause, the Welsh Corky Cardigan. Congratulations! Runner up of FC Group 1, ladies and gentlemen, the Pulley. And the winner, the first competitor for Best in Show on the Sunday, winner of FC Group 1, the Meloa. Congratulations. The first competitor we have, the Meloa, winner of FCE Group 1. We see this dog back on Sunday for Best in Show. Best in Show of the European Dog Show 2016, organized by the Belgium Kennel Club. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we continue now with our next group. Photos are being taken by the International Dog Press, and right now around the world, when people following us through the live stream, they see and they know what is happening here in Brussels. Jos, are you enjoying yourself?
Yes, great. I always do.
Great.
If not, I would not be here.
Great, great, great.
And on Sunday, you can see again the Malinois, Belgian Shepherd Malinois, the Mechelaar.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, ready to roll again, going to the next group. And the next group is FC Group 6, it's the Hound Group. It's a big, large group. And I've just heard that we have a lot of competitors here, so it's a full group. Be aware, ladies and gentlemen, now you will see breeds that you really don't see normally at dog shows. But because this is a European dog show, such a big event, that's why they are here. We also have a very, very special judge. He comes from the country of wine and cheese. He's really an ambassador. He's one with great knowledge who traveled around the world. Give him a warm welcome from Portugal, Mr. Teixeira. Welcome!
Right, you will see a lot of rare dogs because Group 6 is a very, very big group. All hunting dogs. Hounds. And the first is the symbol of the Belgian Cynology. The symbol of the Koninklijke Maatschappij Sint-Hubertus, Société Royale Saint-Hubert, the Sint-Hubertushond. And you have all these different breeds. You nearly never see them just on world shows or European shows. Nearly all of them are real working dogs. That's the reason why you don't see them often in shows. They like to work. Go with the Segugio Italiano, yep. And the porcelain, sometimes very difficult to make the distinction between a porcelain and a billy. The Istrian hound, you saw him, the short hair. And normally we will have also a roof hair. Eastern wire hair hunt. And then we have the Planinski conic of the Montenegrin mountain dog. The Pasavik hound of the Croatian hound. Slicer-Laufhund and the Gonski-Polski. The Alpenlandische Dachsbracke. The Bayerische Gebirgsweißhund. The Hannover Schweißhund. And it is the Griffon Vendien and the Briquet Griffon Vendien. That's the Griffon Bleu de Gascogne, the Basset, and the Griffon Fauve de Bretagne, the Grand Basset Griffon Vendien. And normally we have the Petit Basset Griffon Vendien. The Basset Fauve de Bretagne. The Basset Artigien Normand. And I was missing the Beagle. Here he is. The Basset Hound. So, Mr. Texera, they are all yours. Please pick out six of them and later on go to three in the final.
And ladies and gentlemen, you see, we told you the true story. A lovely collection of rare breeds with a specific hound function in the different countries. Some breeds have just some typical elements why they are differ from the other breeds, but this is really an impressive group being here at the European Dog Show.
Let's have a look to Mr. Texera picking out six of these breeds. And as my colleague said, he has a lot of routine. It's necessary for such a group, surely. And there we go, the Chien de Saint-Hubert. The Rhodesian, which I was thinking also Rhodesian Ridgeback. So also Rhodesian Ridgeback. Then we have the Grand Basset Griffon Vendien, Petit Basset Griffon Vendien, the Beagle, and one more, the Basset Hound. Saint-Hubertus Hound, Rhodesian Ridgeback, Grand Basset Griffon Vendien, Petit Basset Griffon Vendien, Beagle, and Basset Hound. And we start with the Saint-Hubertus Hound. Sometimes they call him Bloodhound, but the official name is Saint-Hubertus Hound. Belgian breed, symbol of the Belgian Kennel Club. Very old breed, born in Saint-Hubert, a beautiful little town in the Ardennes. And I think everybody knows the story of the Saint-Hubertus. Rhodesian Ridgeback, strong, with a lot of elegance, fast, a real hunting dog. Special, they are hunting in groups, 3 to 4. Rhodesian Ridgeback from South Africa. Grand Basset Griffon Vendien from France, where we works in the Vendée. And then his little brother. Or would I say, yeah, the petit basset griffon vendéen. And when you like wines, I'm sure you know where the Vendée is. It's the east side of France. And the most known village there is Bordeaux. And then we have the Beagle. Of course, also a hunting dog, but he is very popular as companion dog. Family dog, why not? But again, this is not a basset. It's normally shaped. The Beagle. We get the Basset Hound, still very popular. When I've seen the entries today, there are a lot. These are the six finalists, and now we go to three, two, and one. That's what we need. Try to judge with the judge. It's always interesting, you have an eye for the dog. So look at them and think, this would be the first for me, the second and the third. Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Why not? Okay, six dogs there. We know the results in just a split second.
Say goodbye to everybody. In the meantime, the results are coming here.
But we have to wait till the judge is at the podium.
The third place is for the Petit Basset Griffon Vendéen.
Congratulations!
Second is for the Rhodesian Ridgeback.
And again, a big congratulations to you as well.
And
the winner.
And who do you think is the winner?
Tell me.
The Grand Basset Griffon Vendéen.
The Grand Basset Griffon Vendéen, winner of the Hound Group.
That was perfectly announced.
And the next competitor for Best in Show, Sunday. Pesh, what are you waiting for? Take some pictures. Sven, is everything under control? Lovely pictures are being taken of the winner, the runner-up, and number three of FC Group 6, the Hound Group. Yes, and the photographers, they are quite critical, you know. Having take a good position, you have to go to each dog, and this is nice. So we have a nice, good
two
two groups to go, dear friends, two groups. We now go to group seven, the pointing dogs, also the working dogs, the real hunting dogs in the field. And the last group of today is group eight. And that's the gun dog group, retrievers, spaniels, and water dogs. But first, now we will enjoy group seven.
Yeah, a little tour of honor. And the winner, we see him back on Sunday.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the ring is ready. The judge is ready. Are you ready? Yes? Okay. Then we continue with group seven. And the Belgium Kennel Club really invited a special team of international well-known judges. And also our judge who will judge group seven is certainly one of them. A breeder of American Cocker Spaniels, an all-round judge from Switzerland, an ambassador for his country and for dogdom. Give him a big welcome, Laura Pichard, welcome.
Now the judge, and now the different breeds of group seven. And we start with the Gordon Setter. And the Irish Setter Red. And the English Setter. The Pointer. Große Münsterlander, the Deutsche Kurzhaar, and the Deutsche Drahthaar. And the Deutsche Langhaar. The Grifo Kortals. And the Weimaraner Longhair, the Magyar or the Hungarian Vizsla short hair, and the Magyar Vizsla Drahthaar, the Spinone Italiano, very popular in the country. And the Draco Italiano, or the Italian Pointer. From the Netherlands, the Drentse Patrijshond. And when you see him, there is the other one, I hope. Yeah, the Stabijhoen. The Gammeldams Kunsehond. And the Sesky Fusek. Portugal. The Brac de Vergne. Brac de l'Ariège. Et le Brac français type Pyrénées. L'Espagnol Picard. And last but not least,
espagnol breton.
So Mr. Pichard, they're all yours, and we ask you to pick out six and later on go to three. All pointing dogs from all Europe.
And now we'll see the selection of our judge from Switzerland, Laurent Pichard, his shard cut. And in his selection, we'll see the English setter.
And also the pointer. And who is coming next? The Deutsche Kurzhaar.
German shorthead pointer. The Weimaraner.
The Weimaraner, yeah. And the Braco Italiano. And one more, please. And it will be the Sabayon. Please give them an applause and congratulations for all these beautiful dogs, for all these beautiful pointing dogs leaving from the main ring.
Thank you very much for presenting your best of breed winners in our main ring. We say goodbye to you now, but we hope to see you back soon at one of our shows wherever in the world. Thank you very much for presenting your best of breed winners in our main ring.
And this is the English setter. An orange belt on, I think. Yeah. English setter. And the symbol of this group. Pointer.
English pointer.
And that's what he's doing. He's pointing. He's pointing different wild animals. And when he is hunting very, very fast. The pointer, or the English pointer. That's the official name.
And now we go to Germany, Jos.
All right. This must be the German shorthair. Very popular. In Belgium, it's a very popular dog.
And a very true working dog.
Yeah.
A dog that goes in a field, does his work, a real companion to his owner. German shorthead pointer. And we stay in Germany for the Weimaraner.
Every year, somewhat 400 to 500 Weimaraners come together to the region of Weimar, the old DDR. This is the Weimaraner short hair, with its typical diluted blue color.
To Italy for the Braco Italiano, a heavy, strong dog with easy mover, with typical lines in skull and muzzle, his typical Braco expression. Easy moving with great extension, typical in top line croup and tail set, the Braco Italiano.
Tell you. Italian pointer, short hair, or the Braco Italiano. And then we have the Stabehun from the Netherlands.
We go to my country, yes. One of our national breeds, the Stabehun.
I love the name.
Stabei.
Yeah, Stabehun. They told me the origin is in the north, in Groningen, the north.
Very correct.
Yeah. So we learned something. And the three finalists. Think about who would you bet first, second, and third.
You must have some favorites. So also do the judge. Also, we all do. This is where it's about judging dogs to the standard.
Number three, the third place, is for the English setter.
English setter, number three of FCE Group 7.
Second, the Braco Italiano.
The Braco. Runner up.
Do you have it on your paper? Because the winner of Group 7 is the Weimaraner.
The Weimaraner. Winner of FCE Group 7. Pointing dogs. And the third competitor we see back Sunday for the half finale for the best in show of the European Dog Show organized by the Belgium Kennel Club here in Brussels. Sunday, if you are here, come back on Sunday to join with us the best in show program. And also you are welcome to come back tomorrow, of course. If you love dogs, this is the place to be for the coming days.
And on Sunday, we will have back in this ring the Weimaraner, and perhaps he can become best in show of this European Dog Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't go home. Stay with us, because we have now the last group, and will be an interesting group. A group that has some very popular breeds, some very well-known breeds in it. So it's very interesting to see who are the winners, who became European champion, best of breed today. Some breeds had excellent entries today, so it was strong competition, fair competition, but interesting to see who will be the winner of FCE Group 8.
And it's a real honor to me to introduce you. Oh, not yet ready. The ring is not yet ready. Remember, Weimaraner, Braco Italiano, and English setter. And look how you take a photo of a dog. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to introduce you one of my colleagues, one of my Belgian colleagues. A warm hand, please, for Mr. Theo Lehnen.
Mr. Lehnen will judge FCE Group 8, Retrievers, Spaniels, and Water Dogs, the Gun Dogs.
You know the judge, it's now up to see the different breeds of Group 8. Three different crosses, Retrievers, Water Dogs, and Spaniels. And we start with Red
Golden Tour winner. And the curly Golden Tour winner. The Chesapeake Bay Retriever. The Golden. The Labrador Retriever. The Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever. And then comes the Barbet from France. Portuguese water dog. And the Spanish water dog. The Irish water spaniel. And the Lagotto Romagnolo, or the Italian water dog. The Deutsche Wachtelhund. The American Water Spaniel. The Kuikenhandje. The English Springer Spaniel. And the Welsh Springer Spaniel. The biggest of the Spaniels. No, this is the Field Spaniel. Spaniel, and this one is the biggest. The Sussex Spaniel. English Cocker Spaniel. And I'm missing one. Yeah, the American Cocker Spaniel.
Wow, what a lovely group.
So, Mr. Lane, they're all yours. 6 to pick out and 3 to place. And it is really a lovely group. First, the retrievers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 retrievers. All the retriever breeds are here. From the flat-coated, and Mr. Lane is looking at him. This is a brown one, a liver collar. Did you see it? You've seen a lot of them in black. This is the first liver collar. The curly coated, the Chesapeake Bay, near New York. The golden retriever, coming from Scotland. And the Labrador, his name, he loaned from an island, Labrador, near Canada. Also near Canada, the Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever. He is coming from Nova Scotia, and he is stalling the ducks. That's the explication of the name. And then we had the Irish Water Spaniel and the Portuguese Water Dog and the Spanish one. And then we have the Irish Water Spaniel. The other one was the Barbet. I'm really sorry, but from here it's difficult to see sometimes. This is the Lagotto Romagnolo. Und die Deutsche Wachtelhund. Pittelhaag. It's a rare breed, believe me. And the American Water Spaniel. Very rare. Totally different. Het Kuikerhondje. And the English Springer Spaniel. And then we have the other Springer Spaniel, the Welsh Springer Spaniel, east of England. Where is he coming from the north, from Snowdonia. And this is the Field Spaniel. And the Clumber. The Clumber Lane, where London Zoo. The Sussex. Sussex Spaniel, a little bit bigger. The English Cocker Spaniel. And the American Cocker Spaniel. And look at them, look at them. Until 1947, they had one standard.
No, they are totally different. In the selection of Mr. Lehnen, the American Cocker Spaniel, the Klumber Spaniel. English Springer Spaniel, the Portuguese Water Dog, the Labrador Retriever, and the Flat-Coated Retriever.
Thank you, competitors, for your presentation of your Best of Breed winners. European champions they became today. Thank you very much. Safe trip home if you are going, and we'd like to see you back again soon, of course, at one of our national or international dog shows, wherever in the world. And we have a nice, very nice selection. And here we see the movement check of the Flat-Coated Retriever.
The Flat-Coated, a combination of power and raciness. That's what it has to be. This time in liver color. And this always wagging tail.
And there we go to one of the most popular breeds in this part of the world. It's the Labrador Retriever.
The yellow one, but there's also a black one and the liver color. The Labrador Retriever, it's indeed a very popular dog. But it's a splendid breed, simple.
And now we go to Portugal, to one of the national breeds of Portugal, the Cada Aqua Português, the Portuguese water dog.
In the history of this dog, you would see that it was a real working dog. It was working with hunters, and not only with hunters, but it was also working in the water to bring the fish in the boat. It's hard work for this kind of dog. And look at his coat. It's very typical for a water dog.
And now we go to Britain for the English Springer Spaniel.
Also in the field, he is very popular, not only in expositions of dog shows, but also in the field. It's a very, very popular breed.
And we stay in Britain for the strongest and heaviest one in the Spaniels. We go to the Klumber Spaniel.
The Klumber. Don't underestimate him. He can run. Even when he is a big dog, he can run like hell. The Klumber Spaniel. Named from Klumber Park.
And finally, we are crossing the big water and we go to the US. And Jos told us already today, that's where they made the American Cocker Spaniel.
Very popular breed, anyway. They have a little work. When you prefer an American Cocker Spaniel, they have a little work. The coat, you have to do them every time, you have to give them a trimming. But these are splendid dogs, splendid characters, very curious, always active with the tail and always happy. That's what it has to be. And now, look at this beautiful line.
Who will be the winner, the runner-up and the third? There's only one person that knows and that decides this afternoon in this group. And this is our Belgian judge, Mr. Theo Lehnen. Just a few seconds, ladies and gentlemen, and we know the second, the runner and the third. And ladies and gentlemen, again, the next competitor for Best in Show.
And as I said, he is coming back on Sunday. So if you'd like to see again, come over. I'm curious.
Me too. I think we all are.
I'm so long in this job, but I'm still curious. Miriam, help us.
Miriam is looking very serious.
And we start with the third place. And the third place is for the flat-coated retriever.
Flat-coated retriever, number three of the Gundog group.
Second. Is for the American Cocker Spaniel.
American Cocker, runner-up, FC Group 8, the Gundogs.
And the winner of Group 8. And we see him back on Sunday. And I invite you to come and see him again. The number one of Group 8 is the Portuguese Water Dog.
Portuguese Water Dog. Winner of FC Group 8. Portuguese, congratulations, and the next competitor for Best in Show on Sunday. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for staying with us. We wish you a lovely evening. Take care of your dogs, take care of yourself with this hot weather. We like to see you back tomorrow and on Sunday. And if not, see you again soon. Drive carefully, bye-bye, and see you soon again.
Also in my name, bye-bye, see you next time.
at the end of a very warm day here in Brussels, and we're here with Hans van der Ven, my very good friend. Hans, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So if you could tell all our viewers today, what have you been doing today? Have you enjoyed your first day?
I enjoyed my first day very much, but I did some breeds you don't know.
Oh, go on, Naya. Yes. Silos Wolfhound.
The Silos Wolfhound, the Dutch Shepherd Dog, yeah, and the Schapendoes.
Okay.
And do you have any Schapendoes in England?
I doubt it very much in England, because we're not an FCI country. Here it is, of course.
So, but I enjoyed it very much.
Yeah.
And I think it was a well-organized day. Easy going, nice rings, good stewards. Yeah, it was perfect.
And how many groups have we had here today? We've had four groups, haven't we?
Four groups, yes. Yeah. So, but I don't tell you what I like.
No. Because Hans is on Sunday our Best in Show judge. And of course, you're an international judge. You've done this many times, of course.
Yes, I did many times Best in Show. And I also did it in England?
Absolutely. And you're judging in England later this year. We're going to let Hans go because I know the bus is going. So, Hans, thank you very much. We're going to bring in another Dutchman. We're going to bring in Ronnie as well. Ronnie Dodeens, you've heard Ronnie. Good afternoon, Ronnie.
Hello, and
Ronnie's been the voice, or one of the voices. You're part of a team of commentators here.
That's correct, yes. Yeah. We have two Belgian guys and one from the Netherlands. But we do the commentary in English.
Right, okay. And, of course, Ronnie is very famous in Amsterdam because you're very much part of the team of the Winners' Show. Is that correct?
That's correct, yes.
Okay. And this year, the Winners' Show is... Give us the dates and a bit of a background, because you have 3 days now, not two.
3 days, yes. On Friday, it's the second weekend in December. Yeah. On Friday, we have All-Breed Holland Cup Show. Yeah. And then on Saturday and Sunday, we have the All-Breed Amsterdam Winner. And this year, we are hosting the show for the 127th time. So one of the oldest dog shows in the world.
And you guys all work very closely together here with the Belgian Kennel Club and the Benelux region, is that correct?
We have also we made a title together, Benelux winner. It's a title you can win when you win a point in Luxembourg, in Belgium and in the Netherlands. And yes, the Belgian Kennel Club, Luxembourg Kennel Club, Dutch Kennel Club, we are also one of the founding members of FCI, and we have a lot of things in common, and that's why we work together.
Which show do you get the Benelux title this year? Because it rotates, doesn't it?
Rotates, yes. It's at this show, it's in combination with the European show. In Holland, it's in Maastricht, in the south. You can still enter for this show, and it's a beautiful show. And
we like a good plug, Ronnie.
Yeah, and in Luxembourg, they have Luxembourg is a smaller country, and they have two big international shows, one in March and one in September.
Again, we better let Ronnie go because the bus is going. We're both getting very hot in here as well. So when you get back to the hotel, I'll have a large Stella, please.
Okay.
Thanks,
you,
Ronnie. We're going to bring the last guest we've got is the chairman or the president of the society, Hubert Isser. And Hubert is actually the president of Saint-Hubert, is that correct?
It's the Royal Society Saint-Hubert, that's correct. Yes.
I'm letting him correct me on that every single time. Why does it have a royal title?
In Belgium, each association that has a tradition from over 50 years, and we have one from almost 150 years.
Yes, I know, longer than the UK,
It's the right to get the title Royal.
Yeah, yes. Okay.
And that's where we have the title Royal Société Saint-Hubert.
It's good to see Hubert sporting a bow tie in the evening dress here, because it's been quite warm today, hasn't it? Is there any chance you can turn the air conditioning up tomorrow?
And it wasn't not even enough, that air conditioning. It's not still hot in the halls.
Well, you've got your first day over, so what's coming up tomorrow? What groups are on tomorrow?
Tomorrow, the group 5, 9 and 10.
Okay.
We will have group 5, 9 and 10. And I have to say, group 10, my favorite group, because I'm a sight hunt man myself.
Okay. Yeah,
can I say it?
But also the same message to anybody coming, don't leave dogs in hot cars. And you do have patrols going around, don't you?
We still have the same measures we had today. Each parking, there are pamphlets that say don't leave the dogs in the car. Everyone who is entering with his car will have a little leaflet on his windshield. There are people patrolling the parkings to see if the dogs were not in the cars.
No incidents, I've not heard of anything today.
There was one moment that we had to interfere but with a Portuguese vehicle. We called them, the people, and they came, so everything was right. There were no incidents.
So we're here at the end of the show, and here's your main ring.
Yeah.
Empty now. You're satisfied with your first day?
I'm very satisfied. It was wonderful. I think Well, if I may say it, we had publicity for dog shows today.
Yes, good publicity for people to come to dog shows.
Okay, so Hubert, again, I'll see you later on in the hotel for a chill-out time.
Yeah, okay.
So thanks very much to our live-streaming guys as well, and they'll be back on air tomorrow. You can see it on the Facebook page for European Dog Show 2016 and also on www.europeandogshow2016.com. I'm even being prompted with that one. So thanks very much, guys. Thanks to Hubert as well. Good night. Okay. Make sure you get Royal Cannon in.
He's the boss. And talk also to the camera, not just straight to that one. So.
Vincent Le... Vincent
Blanc.
Okay, I did say that was the last interview of the day, but there's always a surprise one. We're here with a guy who's actually sponsored a lot of the show, most of the show, Vincent Delplanque. Correct, Vincent?
It's correct. Well done, Vincent Hogan.
Okay. Okay, so you've got the two Vincents. It's a double act. So I believe this is your first ever European dog show, correct?
Yes, right? Absolutely. It's my first European dog show, yeah.
So what do you think? Now you've had the taste of the atmosphere. This first day, of course, so it's not packed. But your stand here is hosting all the judges. So tell us, what's Royal Canin doing here at the show?
Yes, and it's, honestly, first of all, it's amazing to see what has been done today by all the people to organize this event. And I have to say, especially my team, on which I'm very proud of. And as the first European dog show, I have to say that, wow, this is an amazing place. We have seen a lot of breed today, a lot of people that share the same passion for pets that we all share here. And that we shine Royal Canin. And just to speak a little bit about us, it's the first day. We still have Saturday and Sunday, tomorrow and then to finish the show. And please, you will be very welcome to come to our stand. We will share with you a lot of things about for sure product around the new innovation that we have just launched on the PB Protect, but as well, you will have the opportunity to take photos, to have promotions.
I didn't even have to interview him. He was just.
But you will be. But another question, Phil. And then you will be able to meet nutritionists as well, which it's a good opportunity, I think, for you.
And of course, you can't miss your stand because when you come in through Hall 5, you're right there. It's a very big stand, and then we'll perhaps come back on tomorrow. But as you say, they can meet nutritionists. There's a photo booth.
Absolutely.
And actually, you have a pretty big team here, so you've sort of read. And there's some special deals. I know there's some special deals that people can buy. Is that correct?
Absolutely. You can have a lot of different things. Have you seen? We are a lot from Royal Canin here. That's true because we are very engaged on that show. Not only the Belgian people, but people from all Europe that are. Yeah.
You are the regular sponsor, I think, for Saint-Hubert shows, aren't you?
Absolutely, absolutely. It can be in the countries, but otherwise for European shows or world shows, and that's very important for us.
For me and from the media side and from dog people, we're always very grateful to sponsors. So just for tonight, Vincent, from Vincent.
Absolutely.
Merci beaucoup. Danko
Val. Okay. Thanks. Thanks a lot, and see you tomorrow to continue the show.
Absolutely, because he's got nice chilled drinks on top of his lounge up there as well.
Absolutely.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Bye-bye.